1, 2, 3, 4.
Waterlike is an object option in Newton, meaning it can be applied to any type of object. For example, here I'd like to simulate objects that will fall and float on the sea, which I'll represent with a mask. I'll take my background and create a simple mask like this. I'm not going to set any transfer mode on my mask. I'm going to select none because I just need this marker for Newton to understand where the water surface is. Here I've got different objects, which are a buoy, a unicorn, a balloon, a duck, and all these objects have masks to define them. I also have some text, and I'm going to send all this to Newton. Here it asks if I want to separate my objects, because it's detected that there's an object with several masks on it, but I don't need to separate them. And here I am in Newton. I'm going to add a little more gravity. I'm going to take my water, switch it to static with the S key, and go to advanced Waterlike and activate Waterlike. And we'll see what happens. As you can see, I get an immediate result. After that, it's a question of settings and knowing what you want. So, for example, my objects here don't float enough. They're buoys, so they shouldn't be so far below the water level. They should float much more on the surface. I'm going to select them and change the density. I'm going to use a much lower density because these buoys, they're basically filled with air. And this is what it looks like now. But we could also see what it looks like if, on the other hand, I put in an object that's much heavier, for example, where I'll set a higher intensity. My text here pushes all my objects and then it will flow. An interesting detail here is that you can see that my duck isn't quite straight, like the unicorn. So let's go back into After Effects and make a little change. We'll hollow out this part here. And the same for my duck. I'll also remove some material. And to make it easier to see, I'm going to change the color. I've hollowed out the top of my duck so that it's less dense on this part. And then my buoy here, it's the same. My head, which used to take a lot of weight, now contains more empty space. So what happens if I go back into Newton? I've got this result now. I press preview. My duck jumps. This is because it lacks density in relation to its size. It's a small object. I now have objects that are much more stable. We're going to render 260 images. I have a new composition. We can give an effect as if there really were water. Our first water-like example is now complete.
1, 2, 3, 4.
In this new example, we'll simulate a glass being filled with a liquid. We're not going to fill it with liquid, we're just going to change the density of my water-like. Here I have an object that will serve as my water-like that you can see here, which becomes denser in color. I also have a glass, which is a shape layer with an open path. Next to that, I have these layers that simply have a mask on them. So I'm going to send all this into Newton. Then I'll prepare my scene. I'm going to put in a little more gravity. And I'm also going to put in a floor. This object here is a dynamic object. This is going to be my water-like. So I'm going to go to advanced and check water-like. And I'd like my water-like and my glass to be welded together. So we're going to use a weld joint. If I run my simulation, what happens? You can see that there's a problem with the weld joint. An elasticity is created. So to remove it, we're going to significantly increase the substeps. What's the result? Solved. I'm going to give my object a bit of rotation to start with. I'll also increase the density of my glass. And then I'll do another preview. Then we'll have some fun. We're going to take these objects and put them on their sides, and then we're going to throw them inside my glass. Maybe what I need to do is stabilize my glass a little bit. I'd have to throw my objects for a little more than a second. So I'll go back into After Effects. I'm going to select all my objects. I'm going to move them by a little more than a second. That way they won't enter the simulation until that moment. Back to Newton. I'll take these objects. I'll set an initial velocity. So in addition, I can see their trajectory so that they fall correctly. Same for these objects. We'll see what happens. Perfect. I'm going to use my randomizer to mix these objects into the collision groups so that they don't all collide. I'll put 100% here. I'll also change collide width to 50%. However, it still has to collide with my water-like and my glass. In this case, you have to click twice on A to make it collide with the A group, which is the glass and water-like group. It's interesting because instead of my objects stacking on top of each other, one on top of the other, I have a little more depth. Here, the water-like acts much less because I've increased my substeps. I'm going to multiply my substeps by 5, so that's 3 times 5, yawn 15. And let's see the result. You can see that my objects are coming to the surface. Let's animate all this now. I'll select my water-like. I'll go to animation. I'll increase the density of my object between frames 110 and 150. And we'll see what happens. So at first there's no density, and then the density increases and my objects rise. Then we can go even further. We can select my objects and then give them different densities using the randomizer. That way they'll react differently in my liquid. I'll set them between 0, 5, and 2. So there are objects that will float quickly and objects that will most certainly stay at the bottom. So there's no density in my water-like. And now you see there are some that rise more and others that are stuck at the bottom because they're too dense. Well, it looks pretty good to me. Let's do another preview. Maybe these three objects could be a little less dense so that they can rise to the surface. Right now, they're rising nicely. They'll probably lag behind the others. Perfect. I render my simulation. And I can see in After Effects what it looks like. So I said that my liquid increases in density between frames 110 and 150. There, it was very easy to do.
One, two, three, four.
Now we're going to talk a little about the tricks you can do with Waterlike, because Waterlike is a very interesting function. In this scene, I've got an up text that's animated. If you've seen the Trigger-matic tutorial, that'll ring a bell. And then here I have a ball with a ramp and then a box. So I'd like this ball to come down, run down the ramp, and then stop here. But above all, I'd like it to be able to trigger the animation of my up without stopping or colliding with my box. I'm going to launch Newton. I'm going to put walls at the bottom and on the right. I'll set my ramp to static. And for now, I'll put him in dead. If I run a simulation here, I'll add a bit more density. Nothing very interesting happens. On the other hand, I can use my box here. If I put it in Waterlike, I forgot to set it to static. So what happens? You can see that my object passes through and is slowed down a little. Interesting things are going to happen. If I select my box and set the density to 1, mind you, my density is on 1 because my substeps is on 2. So if I take this box, set the density to 1, and set the lift to 0, and do a preview, you can see that there's a slight slowdown. But if I increase it to 1, then my object slows down. So there are things you can do to slow objects down, or we can even do the opposite. Things that accelerate objects. So that's very interesting. And then if I set everything to 0, and if I set this object to Trigger-matic, and if I give it the contacts with the box as a trigger, my object will launch the animation defined in After Effects. Well, I can have this box just act as a trigger, i.e. the object will pass through it. It won't even stop. But Newton will have detected the contact. So we can create a switch that's invisible to the animation. But Newton can use it. These are very interesting little tricks with this Waterlike option, and they make it possible to create incredible animations.
1, 2, 3, 4.